Hi everyone, I'm Pauline, and in today's video, I'll be talking to you about how you can use your iPad to develop software using Gitpod.
Using Gitpod on an iPad is completely possible. And as you can see, I've got GitLab open. And from here, I can start Gitpod by, as I explained in my previous video, by going to this drop-down menu where it says Web IDE. And then instead of Web IDE, I can set it to Gitpod, and we've got this nice, seamless Gitpod button straight out the box. We can click on Gitpod, continue with GitLab. And as you can see, you've got your Gitpod workspace spinning up. And now we're here using Gitpod on an iPad. So you can just start coding straight away. In this case, let's just open up a terminal. And you know what? Since we're here, and I'd like to demonstrate that this is possible even on an iPad mini that isn't as powerful as the iPad Pro, for instance, but we haven't actually set up a Gitpod YAML file in this Next.js app example, so we can automate some of that now. So from the terminal, let's put in Gitpod init. And what this has done is it's created our initial Gitpod.yaml file. And where it says here, let's just remove all of that. And let's initialize with npm install. And then in the command, we'll run npm run dev. And then we'll leave the ports as it is. Then we can just add that as usual. Add dark-gitpod.yaml file. And now if we just go back to GitLab. We've got our gitpod.yaml file added just 22 seconds ago. Then we'll start a new Gitpod workspace. And there you have it. As you can see, our Next.js app has started, and also you can see the npm install run and start the web server as well. And there you have it, coding from an iPad. I also thought this might be a good time to just showcase my colleague Geoff's blog post, just explaining his experience if any of you are interested.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you learned something. If you have any more questions, please feel free to join our thriving community on Discord over at gitpod.io/chat, and we'll see you over there.